Already sewing? Or do you want to learn? Welcome to Power Sewing.
Hi, I'm Ron Collins, and welcome to Power Sewing.
I'm Sandra Betzina.
Now, what do you have up your sleeve for us today, Sandra?
Well, it actually is a sleeve. I love Dolman sleeves. And the reason I do is they're so easy. You don't have to set in a sleeve, and it gives a nice smooth. See, for example, if you have a pattern on a garment, it can be continuous. Like on this one, do you see how I didn't have to interrupt the pattern at all?
It's great for this style.
And what this is Vogue 1081, and I love this blouse. But do you notice, some people tell me, I don't look good in Dolman sleeves because they make me look too short. All the Dolman sleeves I cut are high in the armhole. Do you see how high this is here? And the dress I have on, 1071, I love it, only has three pieces. It has a front, a back, and a front and a bottom and a back. And it's just so simple. You just sew it and it's in knit. But if this is too low, it is very frumpy. Then the other thing that people say is that a lot of times I have problems with garments going to the back. Well, a lot of times pattern makers get lazy and they cut the front and the back dolman just the same. If you'll look at this, here is the seam line. You see the back is longer than the front and it goes all the way down.
Okay.
So I'm going to show you how to fix both of these problems, because let me just slide a typical one. Here's a dolman sleeve from, we'll call it the Unknown Pattern Company. I want you to see this. You see, even though it's not exactly the same, it's cut on dolman sleeve. Let's look at this compared to this one. Now, who do you think is going to look better? I mean, look at all the stuff hanging underneath of the arm. So I'll show you how to change that. Okay, because when I see this, I think, that's not going to be good. So we're going to take the pattern, and the first thing we're going to do is, let's say you wanted to raise the underarm seam. What you can do is you can pinch it, and you can say, you know, maybe I want to raise it an inch. So I'll put, you see how it comes up here, right at the inner curve there, I will mark an inch. And what you want to do is you want to come up, see, go straight up and then out and smooth it so that, you see, it just moves back in the sleeve. We don't want to make the sleeve tight, but we want to raise it.
So you're taking a good bite out of that.
Good bite. And let's say it's still too low. All right, then what I would do is, if I once took out of a Simplicity sleeve 4 inches. It was a coat, and it was a great coat, except it was so horrible down here. So you see, in that case, what I would do is I would keep raising it, and then you sew it. This would be the sewing line. Do you see? I mean, you'd sew it, cut it out. Do you see? This right here, this would be my cutting line.
So make sure you trim away your seam allowance.
Because now, otherwise it won't turn.
Would you keep a 5/8 inch seam allowance, or would you
take it down to 3/8 to a quarter, because otherwise it wrinkles underneath there. So just lift it maybe, you know, 3/4 of an inch, 1/2 inch at a time until you're happy with the way it looks. Now the other thing, all right, now this is the front pattern piece and the back pattern piece. Now let's overlay it on there and let's see. Now if I look at this one, I can see matching it at the underarm that they are identical.
That's not a good thing, because we're not the same size as in the front as in the back.
Right. And so the back has to be longer, or you're going to get this what's called back riding shoulder seam. So what I do, this is so easy, you're going to love it. You can measure, but you know me. I will take 1/2 inch off of the front.
And this is the seam up here, which goes across the back of the arm. Okay.
You know, I'm sorry, I said 1/2 inch, it's 1/4. I take a quarter because I want 1/2 inch difference. So I'm going to take 1/4 inch off of the front, and I'm going to scotch tape it onto the back. And now that immediately changes the way that fits. So you just cut 1/4 off the front and you stick it right onto the back. Now, if your sleeve is more shaped, do you see if it goes like this? you don't have, you know, I love, this one's easy because, you know, it's straight, but if yours is shaped over the shoulder, then what you do is you just reduce the front by a quarter inch and add it to the back. Now, when you put these two together again, let's even color this in so you can see what's going on here. See, this is what we've added. Okay.
Oh.
Now, our front, see, this rolls over just like you saw on the black blouse on 1082. You see, that rolled over so well that now it doesn't have to pull from the back.
Looks good.
So to me, this is really a nice thing. And there's one other thing I do when I do dolman sleeves. Now let me show you something. This is 10, this is that one I love, 1081. Now this is something I do. I don't know whether you probably don't wear dolman sleeves because most guys' patterns don't have them. But when a woman, one of the things you notice sometimes is that a stitch will break under the arm, because it's one continuous piece of fabric. But if you'll do this, if you'll sew it, pull it taut. See, I sew it, clip it a little bit in the seam allowance, pull it taut, see, hear that? A little stitch broke, then I re-sew
it
again. And I do the same thing on the crotch.
Not a bad idea. Now the crotch, you'd stay tape it after a while.
I'd stay tape it, but I'd still, after I sew it once, clip in.
Give it all the stress now and not later, while when you're wearing the garment.
So you're not disappointed. And you know, the thing is, just remember, give these dolman sleeves a chance, because once you get onto them, you are going to love them. And one of the things that I always appreciate is when you've got a continuous pattern, you see, you don't have to match. You know, if you had a big flower, you would see it would go straight across. It's just a really nice way.
Fast and easy way of putting in a sleeve.
So that solves the dolman sleeve problem. So I hope this helps you. We'll see you next time. So what do you think?
About what?
Power sewing.